Today, we are going to explain WooCommerce POS Kitchen QR Booking System. This all-in-one tool simplifies sales, restaurant management, and kitchen workflow. It also supports QR-based ordering, making it great for businesses of any size. So now let's check the workflow. I simply need to put the credentials. After putting the credentials, it will take me to the dashboard of my WordPress website. Now we can already see we have a module here called Restaurant Management. Inside this Restaurant Management, we have Users, Outlet, Products, Order, Drawer Reports, Dining Table, Invoice Template, WhatsApp Greeting Settings, Extensions, Support, and Services. So let's get started with all of them one by one. Firstly, we are going to the User section here in this Restaurant POS Bundle module. We have three types. This as a POS user, kitchen user, and a customer QR POS user. So in order to create a new user, we simply need to click on this button called Add New. After clicking here, we simply need to mention the username. Let it be Jan Smith. Now I need to mention the outlet. Currently I have only one outlet called Washington. Then I need to mention the name. Let it be Jane. Now mention the last name, that will be Smith. Then mention the telephone. Let it be. Now I need to mention the email address. Now I need to mention whether it is a vendor. The status of my user is enabled or disabled. I need to create a password for the same. Now I have to select the user role, whether this user is a POS user or a kitchen user or a customer QR POS user. So in order to do that, we simply need to tap on this button. Now I have three categories as POS user, or I can choose it as a kitchen user, or I can use it as a customer QR POS user. After choosing this, I simply need to tap on this button called Save User. After clicking here, we can see a successful pop-up appears which says POS Manager had been created successfully. Now coming to outlets. At this moment I have only one outlet created. Now, in order to create a new outlet, simply I need to click on this button called Add New. Then I need to mention the outlet name. Let it be California. I need to mention the outlet address. The outlet city is Los Angeles. I need to mention the outlet postal code. Then I need to mention the outlet country, which is India, and the outlet state under this, and it can be changed. Here again, a successful pop-up appears which says outlet had been created successfully. Now moving on to products. These all products came from the WooCommerce end, and we also generated the barcode for the same. At this moment, we have generated the barcode by the ID. Now coming to the order section here, all the orders will be placed from the POS end as well as from the customer QR POS end. Now coming to the dining tables at this very moment, I have two tables, family table and a couple table. Now, in order to create a table, I simply need to go on this button called Add New. Then I need to mention the table name. Let it be Friends Table. Now I need to mention the type, whether it is a square, circle or a rectangle. For this moment, let it be a rectangle. Now I need to mention the outlet. I have two outlets, says Washington and California. Let it be Washington. Then I need to mention the number of seats here, mentioning 5. Now I need to mention this status, whether it is enabled or disabled. For this instance, let it be enabled only. Now clicking on this button called Save Table. Here again a successful pop-up appears, which says the table has been created successfully. Now coming to the settings part. Here these are the general settings. Moving on with the customers. This is the setting for my customer that is a default customer. Then we can add payment from here. At this moment I had added two types of payment as bank transfer and PayPal. I can simply add more payment method. For example, here I can add a UPI option as well. In order to save payment, I simply need to click on this button called Save Payment. Then a success will pop up appear which says UPI payment gateway had been created successfully. Now moving back to payment. Then we have invoiced printer. Then we have an endpoint. In this, we have three endpoints called upon a screen, a picture screen, and a customer QR POS screen. Now coming to the kitchen and customer screen. I need to mention the API key, the auth domain, the database URL, the project ID, the storage bucket, the messaging sender ID, the app ID, and the measurement ID. Then here I need to select this as Firebase, because this whole module is a real-time module. Then coming to the restaurant tables. Here I need to mention the following details, as when my restaurant starts means, what is the opening time of my restaurant. Here I had mentioned 7 a.m. I can change it to 9 a.m. Then I need to mention the closing time. It is 9 p.m. Then I need to mention the duration of the table booked. I had mentioned 45 minutes. Then I need to mention the gap, which is 15 minutes. Now, I have mentioned here the opening days of my restaurant. My restaurant will be open in weekdays only, as Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. After configuring all settings, I need to click on this button and save. After saving, a successful pop-up appears again which says this setting has been saved successfully. Now, coming to the extensions. So, these are all the extensions created by Webkul, only we can refer to these as well. So that was only the admin end of our WooCommerce Restaurant POS Bundle module. So now I'm going to share the POS screen and as well as the kitchen screen simultaneously. So let's get started with that. Firstly, I am going to show the POS screen. Here, firstly, I need to mention the credentials as John Doe and need to mention the password. Now, simply, I need to log in. After logging in, I need to manually draw the amount that will be 500. Now, moving to the dining tables. Here, 4 tables are created. The 3 tables had been created from the admin end. We can also create a table from the post screen only. So in order to create a table from the play screen, we need to tap on this button Create Tables. Then we need to mention the table name. Name the table name, the small table. Now I need to mention the table type. Let it be circular. Now I need to mention the number of seats. Let it be 1. Now I need to mention the status of whether the table is enabled or disabled. Let the table be enabled, and only then do I need to click on this button called Submit. After submitting, a pop-up appears, which says the table has been created successfully. Now, in order to verify whether the table admin created or not, I simply need to go to the tables. Then we can see a small table had been created with seat 1. Now, in order to create a booking, we simply need to go to the table at which we want to create a booking. For example, I need to make a booking for this small table. Here I need to mention the customer. By default, we have a default customer. Then we need to mention the booking date. Now I need to mention the booking slot. After filling in these details, the table will be booked successfully. This type of message will appear. Now I need to go to the booking section. And here I can see with the booking ID Woo9 on the 21st, March, the table name small table had been booked with a time slot 8 p.m. to 8:45 p.m. Here I can add the products. So in order to add product, I simply need to go to this button called Add Product. Now I need to add this product. Now after adding, I simply need to go here called Add to prepare. Now I can give a note to the kitchen, for example. I can say that makes food less spicy. Now this note will be visible to my kitchen owner or kitchen POS user. Now I have added, and we can see that we have been redirected to the kitchen orders page, which says that this order with Woo customer ID 213 and the table ID Woo9 is on hold, and we can go on this button called All Orders. And we can see the order number 211. One and order need 212 had been completed, and order ID 213 is on hold from the kitchen end. And now I am going to the kitchen screen. So in order to go to the kitchen screen, I need to tap on this. Here I have logged into my kitchen screen. Now I can see that order ID 213 is on hold. If the kitchen user had started the preparing, he can simply just click on this button called Start. Now in the real time, the order from the on hold category had been shifted to the preparing category, and at the same time, The user can also see whether the food is under hold or it is preparing at this moment. For example, if this food had been completed from the kitchen place, then he can simply tap on this button called Completed. Then this will be displayed over here, and it will be also displayed over here, which says Dining with Table 9, with Table 9 had been completed. By any chance, and if there is something happens, then the kitchen user can also take the food back. For example, here we have an option called Back to Prepare. The food is completed, but the kitchen user can, by clicking on this button, the food will be came back to its previous state or the preparing state, and he can also make it more previous. Now the food there with Table Added 9 is on hold state. This simultaneously happens at the POS screen as well. So this is for the screen as well as the kitchen screen. Here everything happens on real time. I already told you, the dining facility in the POS screen. We have two types of facilities as dining and takeaway. Earlier I had told about the dining. Now I am going to share the takeaway facility. Again, we have to go to the POS screen and enter the credentials. Need to enter the drawer value. Now I have an option here. I can simply have to switch to a takeaway mode. I simply need to add the items and make the payment. And I have an option either to print the invoice or to skip the invoice. It would be skipped if I chose to print the invoice. In that case, the invoice will be printed. I can choose the type and save it as a PDF. So that was my takeaway module. In order to shift from takeaway to dine-in again, we have a button over here. If we tap on this button, it says you have switched to a dining mode. If again we want to switch to the takeaway mode, we simply need to tap on this button again called takeaway mode. So this was my takeaway. Now coming to the last part of our previous bundle module, which is a customer QR POS. In the beginning, I have already mentioned that there are three types of users: a POS user, a kitchen POS user, and a customer QR POS user. So let's get started with the customer QR POS user. For that, we need to go to the admin page. So here I am at my admin page. Then I need to scroll to users. Here I can see I had already created a user called James Smith as a customer QR POS user. Now, what is the customer QR POS? So let's go to our outlet. And at the Washington outlet, I need to go to the manager outlet. Here at this outlet, I have four tables. We have four tables. And these all four tables have a QR code with a table called family name, couple table, a friend's table, and a big table. So these are the four tables at Washington. Each table has a unique QR code. If a user scan this QR code, he will be redirected to the digital menu for the same, and can add the items over there. For example, if I want to book the family table in Washington, I simply need to scan this QR code. We can simply scan it from the mobile phone. But now I don't have access to a mobile phone for that. I'm just having a screenshot of the QR using the Google Assistant and scanning it. Here a link has been generated. I can simply go to this URL. Here the URL occurs and all the food items have been added as well. Now I can simply add the items to my cart. For example, I had added these items. Then simply I need to proceed. I need to mention the customer username. Let it be Stanley. Then I need to mention the email ID of my user. Here my total is $440. Then I need to proceed with payment. Here the order is completed. This customer QR screen is exclusively for the phone only, because the QR code will be scanned through the phone only. In order to cross-verify, we need to go to the orders of a restaurant management POS bundle. Then we can see on the top I have an order ID that is Wu1540. We can verify it here as well, that Wu1540, and we have mentioned the total is 440. And here the over here also the total's 440 only. So this was all for the restaurant POS bundle. I hope you like it. If you have any queries, contact us at support@theratewebkul.com or raise a ticket at webkul.uvdesk.com.